The National Security Council denies a military shift to territorial defense in the West Philippine Sea gave terrorists a window of opportunity to bomb Marawi. Its Assistant Director General or Director General Jonathan Malaya says the military has yet to begin the shift to territorial defense given lingering internal security threats. Malaya, however, says tighter security in the Mindanao State University Marawi campus could have prevented the incident.
As mentioned by the president himself, we are still in the process of determining the parameters of the shift. Remember, there are still threats that are still present. There are remnants of the violent extremist groups in Mindanao, in the Barm area. There is still the continuing threat, although very much weakened, of the CPP and PA in Mindanao and in the Visayas. So the argument that government has shifted its focus immediately to territorial defense and has somehow neglected internal security operations, I think, has no basis whatsoever.
Meanwhile, Malaya says Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. cannot be blamed for grabbing an opportunity to resume peace talks with the National Democratic Front. He said this in response to Vice President Sara Duterte's earlier statement, which called the resumption of peace talks a deal with the devil. Malaya adds the Philippine government is entering the exploratory talks from a position of strength since it did not agree to any preconditions.
We have to see the Oslo Joint Communique for what it is. It is an expression on the part of the National Democratic Front of an intention or a promise to abandon armed struggle. No, I think this is one angle that a lot of people fail to recognize. The Joint Communique talked about the transformation of the CPP, NPA, NDF. What transformation that will lead to is, you know, the big question. It is now up to the National Democratic Front to show sincerity, because I think that is the Vice President's main point. Is the National Democratic Front sincere and serious about really ending the armed struggle? Through the joint communique, they made a promise that they want to abandon the armed struggle.
The Philippine military looking into a possible failure of intelligence on its end that led to the deadly Sunday bombing in Marawi City. AFP spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar says they are awaiting the results of the investigation before considering intelligence failure. Bangsamoro officials earlier said on the eve of the bombing, text messages circulated claiming there would be a bomb attack. The text did not specify where the attack would happen. 4 people were killed and over 40 people were injured after a bomb went off during a Catholic mass at a local university Sunday morning.
Sa pagkalat po ng sinasabing text messages, ito po ay, I'm sure this will be covered by the investigation that is being conducted now. So we just wait for the result or the conclusion of this investigation for us to answer the succeeding question na kung mayroon bang failure of intelligence or not.
Other news, a graduate of the University of Santo Tomas stops the 2023 Philippine Bar Examinations, where nearly 4,000 takers passed. The Supreme Court announced Tuesday 3,812 out of 10,387 takers passed the exams for a total passing rate of 36.77. USC graduate Efraim Bie obtained the highest rating with a grade of 89.265%. Bie revealed to ANC the advocacy he hopes to pursue.
Just a general advocacy to serve the people as much as I can, to give back to the community, to use the legal knowledge and expertise I gained from my alma mater, USC, for the rule of law, for justice.
In his congratulatory message, President Marcos urged bar passers to uphold integrity, remain true to themselves, and ensure that every Filipino can benefit from a fair and equitable justice system. The Commission on Appointments approves the ad interim appointment of Agriculture Secretary Francisco Tiu Laurel Jr. President Marcos appointed Laurel to the post in November after stepping down as the agency's concurrent secretary. During his confirmation hearing, Laurel said he formed an intelligence and enforcement unit to counter agricultural smuggling in the country. He also recommended amendments to the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act, as well as the creation of a digitalization system to connect the Agriculture Department and the Customs Bureau. The Philippine Health Department is noticing a slow increase in COVID-19 cases in hospitals. The DOH, however, says the situation is manageable. Health Undersecretary Eric Tayag assures the public the government is monitoring hospitals nationwide to see if there is a need to intervene. Tayag sees no need to recommend restrictions nor issue health alerts ahead of the holiday celebrations. He, however, reminds the public to stick with the usual health protocols, such as getting jabbed and masking up. Tayag also encourages the public to undergo testing if needed. Three Filipinos failed to flee Gaza due to Israel's continued attacks. Manila's embassy in Jordan says the family attempted to cross to Egypt but failed with roads leading to the border closed. Philippine officials say some 17 Filipinos are still in the conflict-hit area after 120 of them were evacuated through the Rafah border. Meanwhile, the World Bank is keeping a rosy outlook on Philippine inflation. Its senior economist, Ralph Van Doorn, spoke Tuesday at a briefing in Manila. He says they expect inflation to fall within the government's target range of 2-4% by next year. Doorn says the Philippine economy is expected to get a boost from household consumption beginning this holiday season. But he cited risks that could reverse downtrend, such as El Niño and geopolitical tensions.
We still have to wait and see to what extent there could still be global shocks. El Niño could still lead to higher domestic food inflation, and there still could be a risk that those food prices, increased food prices and maybe fuel prices, could lead to second round effects domestically.